It will be interactive, so please don't feel free to ask any doubt you have. Don't worry that nobody is here. Whether, I mean, it doesn't even matter that what is the doubt, just ask, okay?
Okay. Yeah.
Or else it will be like I'll be speaking to the walls. I feel like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's start with the collections. So, collection is nothing but the collection of objects. Okay. So, we have already seen that what is a variable. So, variable is nothing but a container which holds the value. And just on top of it, we have seen this array. Array is nothing but a collection of homogeneous variables or homogeneous collection of homogeneous data, not variables, collection of homogeneous data. What is the meaning of homogeneous data? The same kind of data that we are going to store in array. Okay. And that was in fixed length. That was fixed in length. Okay. So when it comes to array, array is fixed in length. Whenever we want to make some changes to it, then we can't change it. We can't make the changes to it. Then how to extend, then we have to create a new array, then assign this old array to that. It will be a hectic job. Then what is the solution for it? Then the solution for it is array list. So this array list is nothing but the array as well as a list. So array list is a list of objects. Here also we can say it's a list of homogeneous objects with this homogeneous object with the variable length. So we can add multi, when it comes to array was fixed in length, but here this array list is variable in length. So we can add any number of variables to it. Okay, that is array list. So now how to define this array list? You can, so let me share my screen with you. I think I'm sharing my screen, right?
No. See it.
Okay. Okay, how about now?
Yeah, I can see.
Now, so this is the way of defining the array list or collection of power. So how? First, we have to write this array list. Then what kind of data that we are going to store? That we are here, we are going to store the string data. Then the instance variable of it. Then we are going to create the object. And here, okay, here also. String. Okay, so this is the way of defining, or this is a way of declaring an array. So what did we do? Array list string, the instance variable equal to new array list string. This is the way, okay. Now, how to add the elements? So, he simply in the array we have seen this. How to define an array? Df equal to 2, 3, 4. This is the way of defining an array, and this is the way of assigning a variable. Or we can first declare the array, then we can assign the variable based on its index number. Okay, this is the one way of defining the array. Then we have one more way of defining an array. Then we have to define the length of it, or else it will not work. Of 0 equal to 1 equal to 7. So this is the way we have to keep on assigning the value. So this is the way of declaring and defining the array. Okay. But when it comes to array list, so first we have to declare it. Once we have to define it, then we have to assign the values to it. So how are we assigning the value? So there is a method called add. So add is a method which is available in the array list. Then we have to use that method to add the values. So now here ar.add sa, ar.add ray, dot gar. So this keep on happen adding. So I have added these many elements here. Okay, so what was the difference in the last class? I asked you something that wrapper classes, do you remember?
So I just went through and it was telling about primitive data types.
Wrapper classes are different from primitive data type. So these are the, when it comes to this is, okay, this, this int is a primitive, whereas when it comes to integer, it's a wrapper class of integer, is a class of equivalent class of integer. Got it? So integer is a wrapper class of integer is a wrapper class of equivalent to int. Okay? Got it? So in the collection, we never use the primitive data types. We have to use the objects. So, for example, if you want to create the wrapper, if you want to create the array list of string type, then you don't go with the array list. You don't give it the int. If you go with the int, then it will give an error. Can you see that? It is throwing an error.
Yeah.
What is the solution? The solution for it is the wrapper classes. So the reason behind that is array list will take only objects. It will not take the primitive variables. Then if you make it to integer, then the error will disappear. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is, these are the wrapper classes. Wrapper classes are nothing but the equivalent classes of the primitive data types like integer, float, double, cat, char, then boolean. So we have all. We don't have only single integer. We have all. We have float. Float, we have long, char, okay, etc. So we have everything. So these are the wrapper classes. So in the collection, we use this wrapper classes. In the collection, we don't use the primitive data type. We use the wrapper classes. Okay. So is it clear with the wrapper classes now?
Yeah.
Okay, now we come back to the array list. So array list, as I say that, array list is a collection of is a collection of objects, homogeneous object, is a collection of homogeneous object. So here, each and every item element is treated as a, it's a object, it's not a variable. Whatever we are adding, whatever the memory location created, that's created for the object. So this is an object. That's the reason that it is going to store the data of also kind of object data type. Got it? So string kind of data is stored here. So just you think that, okay, here we can't use primitive data type. We have to use the wrapper classes, objects we have to use. Okay, the next thing. So we have added all the, we have added all the elements to the array list. Now how to print it? Just simply print it. System.out.println AR. Okay, I'll print it. See, this is the output. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni. Okay, we have the output here. Then you have added all the elements, but now you want to make some changes to it. Then how to make the changes? AR.set. For example, you have added sa at the 0th index. Okay, but how to change? How to change? You want to change that sa to sa. Okay, how to do that? Then AR, that is the array list dot set. Which position do you want to change? You want to change at the 0th position, 0th index. then you are changing it. Okay, so you change it. You change it to sa. Okay, then later, then after making the changes, let's see what will happen. So we'll try to print this one more time and see the difference. Have you observed the difference? Then now is changed to SA. Okay, SAA. SA is changed to SAA. So we can use set method to change the value at any position. So we have how many values do we have? How many elements do we have? 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So in the 7, as you know that in the array also, index start from the 0. Same here also, index start from the 0. So this is 0th index, this is 1, 2, and it's keep on going like that. And this is going to be the 7th one is going to be the 6th index. So if you want to make any changes at any position, then you should not count the number of elements and give that particular number. Instead, the count should start from the 0. The first index, first element will indexed at 0th position. So first element will be indexed at 0th, will be stored at 0th index or 0th position. Okay, and the second will be at the first position. Okay, so here then if you want to make some changes at second position also, now ar dot set second comma, then I'll give something else is rather than some. Okay, so now you tell me which element will be changed.
Ga
will change to
is.
Very good. Now how about here, which element will be changed here?
Nothing will work.
Yeah, we have indexed till 6, right?
Yeah.
Yes. So we are trying to make the changes to the 4th element, 4th index. Okay, let's see. Yes. Now the pa is changed to is. Okay. Now, so we have seen the set method. Now let's see the, now we have set that, okay, we have set a value at a particular position. Okay, then how to get a value from a particular position, a specific position? How to do that? By using the get method. Okay, so there is one more method called get method, which is used to get the elements from a specific position from a particular index. Then how? So how to use that method? ar.get, then the position, then the index number. So we are getting the value from the 0th position. Let's see. Can you see this? Get method, then the value. Yep, so and if any position we can access from here, any element from any position. Exception, the reason behind, we don't have that 7th index, index out of bond for length 7. So let's see now, 6th position. See, then we'll go to the next one. So we have set one value, or we have made modified one value, then we get that modified value. Now how to remove a value? So we don't want, so accidentally we have created an element array list of 7 elements, but we don't want that, and we want to delete this is element. Okay, we want to delete this is element. Then how to remove that? So this is element is at the 4th index, then we can remove it by using the remove method. How to do that? ar.remove, then the index number. So what is the index number of is? That is 4. So let's see now. So we have removed the element is from the array list, which is at the index 4. Now let's see. Yes, now the is removed from here. Sa, re, ga, ma, is, da, ni. So is was removed from here. Okay. So now last one more. But here you don't want that array. You want to remove all the elements from it, and you want to reinsert the value. Then how to? So remove method will help us to remove an element from a specific position. So 5th position, 6th position, 0th position. So that will help us to do. So if you want to remove all the elements, then what do you have to do? You have to use it, remove method, for all the number of elements. So for example, here we have 7 elements. So all the 7 times you have to use it. But just think about it. If you have thousands of elements, then how will you do? It will be very tough. So in that case, we have one more method called clear. Okay, so one more method called clear. So when you use a clear method, then everything will be clear. There will be nothing in the array list. See, a blank array. Now here you can add, again if you want to add some elements, then you can add the elements. Now check again. Yes. So this was the initial array. Then after that, we use a set method and change the value from SA to SAA. Then we use the get method and we get the value at the knee, which was the 4th position. 6th position, we get the value from the 6th position. Then we just print, after that we print the value. Yes, we use the remove method. We use the remove method and we remove the value from the first index. Then after that, we use the clear method. Then we print the value, there was nothing. After that, we re-add the value here. Is it clear?
Here array list is kind of defined. Always we need to use that, right? Like how we used one scanner and so. Is it like that?
Right. So array list is a class, okay? Array list is a class. Array list is available in the util Java. Java.util package has that array list, okay? The Java.util. Okay, java.util package at array list, then we have to first import the java.util package, and after that we can use this array list. So it's a predefined class. So few days ago, when we were talking about the classes concept, objects and classes, so we have created the object of the class, then we have used the methods of it. Do you remember? Aruti, are you there?
I think internet issue, disconnected.
Okay, fine.
Shoshri, are you getting?
Yeah, yes.
Okay. So, shall we wait for a few moments, Mohan?
Yes.
Okay. Get her back, yes.
Sorry, I got disconnected, power issue.
Okay, no issue. So, I was talking about, so I think in our last session we have seen the classes, the concept of classes, where we have created one, whenever we create a new class, then we have to access the properties and behavior. That means simply in order to access the variables and methods of that particular class, we have to create the object or not?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is a roll number was a class, roll number was a class, and we have created the object of it, d dot. Then after creating the object, we can access the variables and methods of it. So after creating d variable or d instance variable, which is simply called as an object, we use that d object to call the method name set name and set roll number, right?
Yeah.
In the same manner, here also we did the same thing. So we have created the object of ArrayList. Okay, ArrayList is a class which is in the utility package or util package. We created the object of it. After creating the object of it, we just call the method. So add method belong to the ArrayList class, and we just call that method. So when we call that method by passing one data, that is sa, then it goes to that particular variable and set it, or just assign it inside. There is one more variable, so this data went and assigned to that variable of the ArrayList class. Okay, then when we call set method, then this has also happened the same thing. So there was a method inside the set. Okay, there is a method called set in this ArrayList class that generally set the value to the specified position, at the specified position. Then there is a method of get of this ArrayList. So whenever we call that get method with the position number, that will give us the value which is indexed at that particular position. Then next, remove method. So same applicable to remove and clear. So whenever there is a clear method, whenever we call a clear method of ArrayList, then that clear all the objects or all the elements of that the ArrayList class. Okay, is it clear so far?
Yes, now it's clear.
Oh, so I'll do one thing. I'll add this code there. Sushri, do you have any doubt? Okay, so Makan, do you want to add something here?
I have one more doubt.
Mm-hmm.
Here you're calling the method ArrayList, right? It's in method ArrayList, and you're calling that, you are adding that class like ArrayList string. So both can be same.
No, I think I do one thing. I just I'll make the changes to it. I made. So we should not give something as same name as a class. I have given something else now. Okay. So to make it simple, I made this array list 1 1. Okay. Yeah, your doubt is absolutely right. So the ArrayList class and the ArrayList method, both are different. So this is the ArrayList class, which is a predefined class from the util package. And this ArrayList 11 is a method which we have defined. We have written this method and we are using it. Okay. So both are different.
Okay.
Our class name is main and we have created object of it, and we called the method called ArrayList 11. Got it?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Now we'll go with the next thing in our list is called linked list. Okay, so I'll hide this one. Or shall I delete it?
So, Ravi, just I want to add one thing. So, especially when we talk about the collection in Java, so this is actually helpful from a framework point of view. Okay, when you work in framework, you have to be very very clear with the collection concept. Otherwise, it would be very difficult to manage your framework. And this collection will give some advantage, use of collection, so that you can perform like a data kind of things. You have a bulk data and for you need to search or you need to sorting, right, the data, or manipulation, deletion, a lot of things you do with the data part, right? So with the use of collection, you can do the searching, sorting, even manipulation, deletion, anything you can do. So basically we use collection for the data, data management point of view. This is what the purpose of collection especially. That's it.
Okay guys, now let's see the next collection item, that is called linked list. Okay, so let me tell you guys, linked list is also variable length list of items or list of objects. It's a collection of object. Linked list also same collection of object of homogeneous data with a variable length. Okay, and which is quite similar to ArrayList. Okay. Let's see first, then I'll tell you what is the difference. Linked list. Okay, we'll do one thing, we'll manually do it. So is it happening? Yes. Akhan, do you have any idea why is it not taking?
Just uncomment CD that array, na 11 what we put, just uncomment this. No, in main method, yeah. Just uncomment.
Right. It's, so we have to create one more method. That's the reason. I got it. So we'll create a new method. Linked list 11. Yes.
Or we can do in main method also, not an issue, right?
We can do that. The only thing is that I want to make them understand that yes, we already started the classes concept, so why don't we use it? That's it. Now see, so I'll tell you guys what was happening here. Maybe you also learn. So whenever we define or any kind of, when we perform any operation, so we can't perform this operation inside the class. We require a method. To perform any operation, we require a method. So that was the issue happening just few moments ago. When I try to define linked list outside, within the class, not in a method, and it was not at all getting, the methods were not at all populating. So now just check this, hello dot. All the things are available here now. This is a learning point again. Now we will prepare. Now see this, so whatever we have added till now, so here also we have added few elements called sa re ga ma pa dha ni. We have added to the linked list. Then after that we printed that. Let's see. So now can you guys tell me that what went wrong here?
I guess it's the last one printing clear.
No, but nothing is printing here. What might be the wrong? What might be the...
We didn't say it in main method. We didn't call this function.
Right. So we did not call that method. So it's not showing here. So what we have to do, we have to call the method. Now see, this is display. So the same add method which we used in the array list is applicable here also in the linked list. Okay. So add ar.add. Then I say we have added all the elements and all the elements have got added to the linked list. Then we'll see one more now. Now we use the set method. Use the set method. So we are setting the value at second position. Then we are adding the Mac, we are adding Mac at second position, we are adding ease at fourth position, and we are displaying it again. Let's see now. So this is also working similar, quite similar to that. So no need, so what I'm trying to say is all the methods which are applicable to the array list are applicable to the linked list also. So there will be no much difference. Okay, there will be no much difference. So everything will be same. Then where the difference comes? So difference comes when the linked list, the way of they made of, they may of they built of. So the array list is a simple array. Array list is built in a such way that it's a simple array. Okay, it's a simple array. For example, we have five elements. The five elements will be stored in an array. But here we are doing what? We are just dynamically adding the values. Whenever we are adding another value, then what will happen? So initially, how many values we are adding? Accordingly, it will create one array. Then when we add more values to it, then it will create a new array and shift these elements to the new array. So old array will be deleted and new array will be created. That is the way the array list is built up. But when it comes to, linked list. So linked list is made up in a such way that it is a kind of a train. So how train will be linked to? So first we'll be having an engine, then followed by all the bogies will be attached to it. In the same manner, this linked list also, we will be having one variable, and that variable will link to the next variable, and next variable link to the another variable. That will be keep on going on, guys, keep going on. So this is the way that linked list is made up of. So this is the difference. Then in which case do we have to use the array list and in which case we have to use the linked list? So whenever you want to access the values randomly, so you want to pick the value from any position, from a position, then you use the array list. But if you want to pick the values from the first or from the last, or we want to loop through the array list, then in such case we have to use the linked list, guys. Okay, then I did not show you one more thing. Just we have here, when we print an array, when we print AR, then it print in a complete array. It print in an array form. It did not print in a single, each and every element did not print in a separately. It print in an array. Can you see this round square brackets? So how to print them? How to print them as a single, as a individual elements? For that we have to use the for loop. We have to loop through. Okay, for string A in AR. Now print A. Now see the difference. See, now here we loop through. Now the elements are printing in a as an individual elements. Now can you see, the first is printed as an array, whereas here each and every element individually printed over there. So whenever you want to access the value, then you have to loop through. Okay guys,
so array list and linked list the difference you said it links, right? But nothing can be seen on screen, right? It prints the same as how array list prints.
Yes, so it is the way the way those lists are, array list and linked list is different. The way they built is different, okay? So it is not at all related to us. It is just, we have learned that encapsulation abstraction that. So whatever is required for us, we, it's better that we learn that, okay? Inside, I'm talking about internally, those things are built in a such a way. But that is the only difference. And second difference, as I say that, it depends upon that, how do we want to use it? So whenever we want to use it, whenever we want to access the values randomly, okay, then we use this array list and we use the get method. But whenever we want to loop through, whenever we want to loop through, we have to access all the elements, one after another from the starting to the last, then we use this linked list. So name it says linked list. So a small number of variables will be linked to each other. So for example, in this case, we will see how did it happen.
So, sorry to interrupt. So, coming to Parvati's question, so the difference between, you know, link and array, in a linked list, especially you can store a duplicate element, okay, like 100 times. If you want to, suppose, can you just show me that code in IntelliJ, Ravi?
Yeah.
The program which you... So if you want to add ar.addsa many times, you can just add it in case of linked list. Means duplicate, you know, elements are allowed with the same method, under the same.
That is, I'm coming to it. So I thought when I complete both, when I first differentiate this, then when you use the set at this time, I want to tell that what was the difference. Okay.
Yeah. Sure.
So linked list and array list both can have duplicate values. Set cannot have, but what is the main difference between the linked list and array list is, so array list, the structure they built is different, and the way we use, based on that we just select whether we want to go with the linked list or the array list. Okay, got it?
Yes.
Let's say this. Okay. Guys, so this is the array list and this is the linked list. Is it clear now?
Yeah.
Yeah, Makhan. So do you want to add something here?
No, it's okay. So we can continue.
Okay. Now next thing that, so additionally for this, what is the difference then? As I see that, whenever we want to get the values continuously from first to last, then we use this. Then in that case, there are few more methods which are specific to the linked list. Then what are they? So there are few methods called a dot Can you see this method? Add first, add last. So we use this method, add first. So what do we have? Add first. So we have now we have a platina at the first position. Now let's see. Can you see? So before platina, Ravi's got added. Then after Electra, Makhan got added. So these are the specific methods for the linked list. So such way we have few more methods. So we can add the value at the first, we can add the value at the last. But we don't have that opportunity, or we don't have this facility with the array list. So whenever you want to add something at the beginning, you can't add. So what do we have to do? So in the last, this is a different guy. So we have seen the set method. So when we use the set method, it was setting some value at the specified position. Now check, don't check this value, check here. See, Mac is got added at the zeroth position. But what was removed? Sa was removed. So it replaced the Sa. It didn't add the first position. It replaced the Sa, and he just got seat on that position. When it comes to, when we have checked, when we use this method, add first, add last. When we use this add first, add last. So it was not replaced. It is not replacing the value of the first position and the last position. Instead, it is inserting one value at the zeroth position and pushing the other values to the next position. Okay, just give me a second, guys. Sorry guys, I'm back. Yep. So I was talking about the first and last method, add first and add last method. So you may have already experienced that. When it comes to array list, when we are adding something at the first position or the zeroth position, zeroth index, then it was not adding the zero position, it was just replacing the value. But when it comes to add first and add last, it's rather than replacing, it is creating one, okay, it is actually adding the values at the first and the last position. So far, is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now, how to, so in this case, just think about it, you have multiple or you have number of elements in one linked list, and how to get to know that which is the first element. Then for that, we have method called get first. Then we also have the method called get last. Not get lost, it is get last. Okay, see this. You see this? Ravi and Mark. Okay. Any other doubt, guys?
No, good for now.
Makan, do you want to add something?
It's okay. I think there are other methods also there, but I think this should be fine for basic understanding. Otherwise, you know, they will get confused.
Right.
There are a lot of methods available for this collection.
Absolutely right. There is one more we'll see. Just last method I'm going to show you from this. We have used remove method, okay? When we use remove method, then the object or an element from a particular index was getting related. But here we have methods called remove first and remove last also. So I'm going to use only one method rather than two. We have already seen that what happens. So when I use this remove first method, then let's see now what will happen. Yep. So what was the first element? First element was Ravi. But Ravi is removed from here. The same will happen if I use the remove last, the last element will be removed. Yeah. So this is all about the array list and the linked list. So Makan, shall we proceed with the hash map or hash set, or what do you say?
I think we should stop if you feel, because you know because rest they should continue, like you know, Raghu and all especially. So I think. Yeah. Or what, Parvati, are you ready to, you know, take another session for this, the topic which he is going to cover?
No, I